Hello and welcome, I'm Lucy, this is my accordion channel, and if you've clicked on this video, I assume you play accordion or you're thinking about playing accordion. Today I'm going to show you a practice technique to help you bring your left and right hands together. So this technique is called ghosting. This was taught to me from my piano teacher way back in high school. Although I learned it on piano, I found that it applies really well to accordion and any other instrument where your left and right hand are playing different notes and you're struggling to bring them together. This is a really great technique because it helps get you sort of in the middle of hands together and hands separately. So I use this with really difficult passages of music that are just too much for my brain to think about all at once. So to explain this technique to you, basically you separate your left and right hand and you play the notes for one of them while you pretend to play the notes in the other hand, but really you're just hovering over the keys or buttons and just ghosting. I don't generally get a new piece of music and start ghosting straight away. It's something I'll only use once I've learnt the music as best I can, but I'm really struggling with certain parts of it to bring the hands together. I don't recommend you sit down straight away and start to ghost from the beginning. You're gonna have to really do some work to learn the notes of the left and right hand first. So I've broken it down into steps just to explain it a little bit easier. The first step is to just learn the left and right hand separately really well, really know what's happening, be able to play it with your eyes closed in your sleep, know it really well. If you jump ahead and try to bring things together too soon, you'll end up making mistakes that lead to habits which will be really hard to break later down the track. So once you've learned each hand separately really well, you'll pick one of them to focus on. For the purpose of this example, we'll just talk about the right hand. So what you'll do is you will actually play the right hand while your left hand just makes some movements. I guess this would be step two, right? So your left hand is just gonna be moving around, not playing anything, not even trying to play anything, and the right hand will play the melody. If this is really hard for you, just focus on this. Don't move any further. Don't want to overwhelm yourself. Make sure you can do that. It's kind of like doing this. I remember doing this in primary school and it was like the hardest thing to wrap my head around. This is what you're trying to do in this second step. The third step is to actually start ghosting the left hand. So you will pretend to play the notes while your right hand actually plays the music. Now do this at a really slow tempo. The first time you do it, it's going to be overwhelming and confusing as your brain tries to adjust to what's going on. You'll even find your left hand accidentally starts to play the music because it's not used to pretending. Just stick with it, play it really slowly. And don't worry if your left hand is ghosting incorrectly. Your focus is playing the right hand without getting too distracted by the left hand. Still make your focus the right hand while, you know, a small part of your attention is going to the ghosting side of things. When you're feeling like you can do that really well, bring the tempo up a little bit or to your performance tempo, whatever you think you're ready for, and repeat the same thing. Ghost the left hand, play the right hand. After you've done that, try and actually play the left hand and the right hand together, not with any expectation that you'll be able to do it perfectly, more just so to check in, just to see if anything feels differently. You're not done with the ghosting yet because we have to reverse it. You're going to play the left hand while your right hand just makes some motions, nothing particular. Second step, bring the tempo down, play the left hand, ghost the right hand. Third step, raise the tempo, ghost again, and then try bringing hands together and see if you've made any developments. It's really important to know that this is not a quick fix. You can't sit down and play this once and expect it to solve all your problems. Just like any practice, it's going to require repetition, focus, and it will feel like a challenge. If you sit down to practice and it's a piece of cake, you're thinking about other things, your muscle memory is just leading the way, you're not really practicing. It should take extreme focus. Okay, so now I'm going to grab my accordion and just run you through how I would apply this to indifference. I'm going to play the right hand and just make some movements in my left hand. Slow down the tempo and go to the left hand. Speed it up and go to the left hand again. Now I'm going to try hands together. Switch it up, play the left hand, and just make some movements in my right hand. Now I'm going to slow down the tempo and go to my right hand. And go to the right hand. Okay, so I just want to mention when I would use this practice. So I've already highlighted that this is a good practice to use when you're trying to bring your left and right hands together. But there's a second instance where I find this really helpful, and that is using it as a diagnostic tool for your weak points. So I'm sure you can relate to the feeling of learning a piece of music, then you go to perform it, you go to play it for your teacher in your lesson, or you go to record it, and suddenly things are just falling apart. What's happening is your nerves are interrupting your muscle memory, and it's testing your intellectual memory, how well you actually know the music. It's never fun when this happens while you're trying to perform. So what I do is I diagnose these problems before I perform. So what I'll do, I'll take a piece of music that I feel that I'm playing really well, and I will ghost it. Your weaknesses are gonna come out. Jumps that you were getting really well are suddenly you're going to be missing, and that means you need to practice that. This isn't the only practice tool I use. There's a lot of other things that I implement as well, but I just thought this was a really good one to start with because I know the challenges of bringing your left and right hand together. I really hope that this helped you in any way. If it did, give this video a like so that I know, and let me know if you have any other questions, anything else that you're struggling with, and I'll see if I can help you with that as well. All right, bye.